Human beings couldn't change themselves. In fact, no amount of judgment, deliverance, repentance was changing Israel. We'll see that unfold in the book of Isaiah. It took God himself to say and act. He says, I will purify you. I will circumcise your heart. If I can borrow from the language of Deuteronomy and Moses.
Plan of redemption is progressively done. The Old Testament's about the death of a son and a resurrection to come. But this is seen in several aspects of the text that are one. First in this verse I'm spitting, turn attention to death and resurrection in the theme of circumcision. Adam was God's human son in his image, commissioned to reproduce sons that are sinless, who'd love God with all their heart and the soul. So it's just law, always they guard and uphold. Adam was to pass on God's image to his offspring. But since the fall, his children are wicked and they all sin. Now they reproduce a ghastly sinner. So God comes to Abraham, a second Adam figure, blesses him to be fruitful with multiplication. This promise to Abram to resurrect all of the nations. Circumcision's the sign of this covenant, a picture of blessing and a reminder of punishment. A curse, dual sanctions is double meaning. The blessing's the fallen Adam nature of his sons he's cleaning, thus enforcing them to cut the foreskin. Cleansing symbolized on the reproductive organ to reproduce image bearers who love God, it's him they cherish in covenant like in a marriage. But circumcision also has a curse within it. For cut off, karat is the Hebrew verb that's written. Cause just as Yahweh showed, if he breaks his promise, he'll be cut off like how when he slayed the carcass. Likewise, any uncircumcised one in the nation, not circumcised in heart, but they're faking. Here's the judgment they're facing. They're cut off from God, exiled for their covenant breaking.
Gotta infiltrate your sections with Christ.
In Deuteronomy chapter 10:16,
circumcise the foreskin of your hearts instead of them being stubbornly sinful and hard.
Without this, there's no keeping of the law. They're receiving it in awe. Moses sees that they will fall, cut off from Yahweh for evil that they saw. But God will do what they can't, cause his people they are flawed. So in God's word it's written, restoration and return from exile will come with heart circumcision. That's the true abundant gift. Deuteronomy 31-6, the promise of the new covenant. As I read it, my eyes get large. Yahweh promises to circumcise their hearts. Resurrection being performed is essential, both on an individual and a corporate level. Hence Ezekiel 36-37, the Spirit works the blessing of new birth and resurrection. Cause the same one who removes hearts of stone also resurrects from the tomb fallen bones. And all these promises start to be accomplished by God when one Israelite turns to him with all of his heart. All these promises start to be accomplished by God when a Torah keeper turns to him with all of his heart.
Gotta infiltrate your sections with Christ's death, burial, and resurrection.
Christ's death and resurrection is the main theme of the whole Old Testament.
Gotta infiltrate your sections with Christ's death, burial, and resurrection.
Christ's death and resurrection.
Every commandment he did them, the lamb he was given to be cut off out of the land of the living. When he was destroyed for you, he was bearing the covenant curse that circumcision pointed to. Cut off from the Father, stricken with stripes, Paul called the cross the circumcision of Christ. Buried the old Adam, order risen with might. As life-giving spirit, he's the giver of life. Now we're the true circumcision, a part of his new creation, his renewed church that's in him, raised up by his grace so we're able to obey. It put off the old Adam, slave who's in the grave, renewed in the image of the Son restored. With circumcised hearts, now we can love the Lord.
Lord. We were headed for hell, couldn't better ourselves. God's solutions, Colossians 2, 11 and 12. Christ put off the body of the flesh. That's the Romans 6, 6 body of sin and garnished to death. The cross was the instrument to end sin's imprisonment. Buried together, the two we went in with him. So both circumcision and baptism point to union with Christ who has risen. Instead of circumcision, it's the sacrament that's given. So go baptize your kids if you have children.
What a judgment.